Greetings. I am the Militant Negro, and this is my YouTube network. And I have some news tonight that should be of importance and concern for everybody. Dylann Roof has been found guilty. That is correct. Dylann Roof has been convicted. The jury in Dylann Roof's federal trial deliberated less than 2 hours and convicted Mr. Roof on all counts of hate crimes, obstruction of religion, and weapons charges. The panel of 9 Caucasians and 3 Negroes will reconvene on January 3rd, 2017 to decide whether Mr. Roof is sentenced to death or life in prison without parole. Minutes after the verdict was read, Roof told U.S. District Judge Richard Gergel he wanted to represent himself during the penalty phase of his trial. Fox News reports the verdict came after days of emotional testimony from people who survived the shooting and witnessed the aftermath. During closing arguments earlier that day, Assistant U.S. Attorney Nathan Williams told jurors Roof waited until the Bible study group had its eyes closed for prayer before he opened fire. That's not something that I knew before that was made public. Williams also said Roof, who posed in photos with the Confederate flag that appeared in a racist manifesto, believed Negroes were animals and less than human. He violated the sanctuary of the church and killed 9 people. Those people couldn't see the hatred in their heart any more than they could see the .45 caliber handgun and the 8 magazines concealed around my waist. On December 8th, this particular blog that I follow posted daily updates. They have videos on that blog site for you to see a lot of different things. Like criminal defense attorney John Burris speaks about the sentencing phase and what Roof might argue in representing himself. The name of that blog and the link to that blog will be in the description section of this video in the box below. We hold these truths to be self-evident is the name of that blog, and they have been posting information about this trial from back when they were selecting the jury. So check out, we hold these truths to be self-evident. A good friend of mine, Zena, is the one who runs this blog. It's very informative, and these videos will give you some insight into this entire case. I'm just happy that Mr. Roof was convicted, because there's been a rash of Caucasian people, whether they be law enforcement officers or George Zimmerman-like idiots, who kill people of color, not just Negroes, but people of color, period, because they believe they are superior to people of color. These racist people believe they are supreme, and that people of color, especially Negroes, have no good reason to be breathing. They don't think that Negroes and people of color are human beings. They feel it's their obligation to treat people of color less than they would treat animals, pets. Dylann Roof posed in his backyard with the Confederate flag and with all his racist paraphernalia. He used this stuff. He posted it on Facebook. He wrote a manifesto. He belonged to white supremacist groups. And everybody knows how I feel about the term white supremacist. There is no such thing as a white supremacist. I've explained this before. No group of people, no race can be supreme or feel supreme when they can't do anything on their own without the help of other races doing the actual work for them. Slaves were used to build the United States of America from nothing after the Caucasians stole it from the Native Americans and the indigenous people. They imported slaves over here. They brought slaves from Africa and other parts of that region and made them do the field work, raising their crops, tending their fields, made them cook for them because they couldn't cook for themselves, made them raise their children because they didn't have the skills to be parents. So if you can't do your own jobs, if you're not capable of doing your own menial labor, there is nothing about you that is supreme. White supremacy is a myth. It's a fallacy. It's an oxymoron. It actually does not exist. Nobody who needs to depend on slaves and hired help to do their work is supreme. I just want to make that clear. And Dylann Roof is a prime example of how white privilege is rampant in American society. This young thug terrorist walked into an AME church, slaughtered 9 worshipers, parishioners, during a Bible study session, and was taken alive. He walked out unharmed, not a scratch on him. Yet and still, there are hundreds, thousands of police officers who are gunning down unarmed United States citizens in their homes, in their front yards, in their neighborhoods, in the streets, in the malls, any place a person of color is suspected of having a weapon. Police officers open fire within seconds of arriving on the scene and execute that person of color. Traffic stops for Negroes is the most dangerous thing I can think of. Yet still, this Caucasian boy walks out of a church after massacring 9 people and nothing is done to him. There are no shots fired at him, no shots fired into his body. He is not roughed up, beat up, nothing. He didn't hang himself in his jail cell, aka Sandra Bland, among others. He didn't get choked out. He didn't have a fit or anything, nothing. He was treated like royalty. If this is a true story, the cops who arrested his ass stopped off at Burger King to buy this sucker a meal on his way to be processed at the jail. When was the last time you heard of anybody you know arrested for massacring 9 people gets a trip to Burger King before being booked and processed? This is what I'm talking about the Americas being full of shit. Dylann Roof killed 9 people, admitted he killed 9 people, said so in a video that he killed those 9 people, bragged about it, had a hit list of other churches he was going to visit had he walked away from this without being arrested. And he is taken alive. 73-year-old Francisco Serna, a dementia patient, was shot dead in the street on Monday because he had a crucifix in his pocket and some crazy ass white woman said it was a gun. Do you understand where I'm going with this? Caucasian people can kill people of color. They can kill women. They can murder and slaughter children. They can do all types of mass shootings. They can kill people of the lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender community, and they get taken alive because they are mentally unstable. Poor things don't know what they're doing. They're not in their right mind. But a black kid walking down the street is a thug when he gets executed. A kid walking home from a convenience store with Skittles and Arizona iced tea in his pocket and his hoodie up, running because it's raining, can be executed by a punk ass, sissy, P piece of shit George Zimmerman, neighborhood watch punk, and nothing happens to him because he killed a thug. But people like Dylann Roof and George Zimmerman are not thugs. George Zimmerman is a hero. Dylann Roof is just a mental person. He's got mental issues. The real victim here is the American public, because they're just patrolled and profiled by racist cops, a law enforcement agency and community who doesn't care about their rights and their liberties or justice. So Dylann Roof is guilty. Getting back to the subject of this video, Dylann Roof is guilty on all charges. And January 3rd, 2017, the jury will reconvene to discuss whether he gets death penalty or life in prison with no parole. I think Mr. Dylann Roof should get the same thing done to him that he did to those 9 parishioners. He shouldn't get a chair. He shouldn't get an injection. He should be stood against a wall and shot however many times he shot those parishioners at Emmanuel AME Church. That should be his punishment. No hood, no nothing. Just stand his ass against a wall and open fire. Happy holidays. Peace out. Namaste. Be well and stay safe, people.
Talking about the ghetto. Funky, funky ghetto. Trying to survive. Trying to stay alive.